This is a sketch I drew one evening when I was recovering from a cold. I had a few minutes and I wanted to draw something pretty fun and gestural. And I also wanted to explore how to use and maximize the visual effects that this Kuratake fountain brush pen require. And I'm just drawing some hollyhocks that of a photo I found online, and I'm using my iPhone as the image, you know, as my screen to work from. So, you know, you don't need anything fancy to work on your sketching habit, and you don't need a ton of time. Now, I have noticed that whatever I use to draw with when I'm sketching will affect the outcome of my drawing. And what do I mean by that? I mean that a lot of times when I'm working with a pen like this, this is a Kuratake number 13 fountain brush pen. It is very similar to painting because the tip of that pen is actually like a paintbrush, and then ink comes through it. And this ink actually is considered indelible in that it is waterproof after it dries. However, as you'll see when I complete this drawing, I use a little bit of water with a paintbrush, and I can turn it into almost, this drawing turns into almost looking like an ink wash drawing, which is wonderful. And let's talk about the structure and what am I doing. So I am just slowly building up this drawing. I'm not drawing. I didn't like create tick marks to know that I'm going to work with between a certain spot. Instead, I just started. And the very top stem of the hollyhock becomes what I judge all my other measurements off. And I'm just slowly working down and making judgments. And one of the fun things about when you work with this brush pen is that the pressure you put into will affect the thickness of your line. So if you're using a very, very, very light touch, your line is going to be thinner. But then if you apply just a little bit more pressure, it fattens the line. And I absolutely love the variety that you can get out of this brush pen. It's magnificent is all I'm going to say. This is pretty much a contour drawing in that I am looking at the contours more than everything. Every so often I'll put a little bit of hatch marking in to add a little bit of like visual tone. But the majority of this drawing is really just it's a contour drawing where I'm looking at the edges and boundaries of the shapes and putting them in. And you'll notice I'm not being super exact because that's not the goal of this drawing. This drawing was just to play and have fun. And I think that's that's the best thing about when you pick up a sketching habit is that it gives you opportunities to explore and test. And I also feel that it also opens up your mind to allow for more experimentation and mistakes. And here we go. So like here, because it isn't fully dry, the ink spreads out and it can kind of get a little bit ink washy. I'm just using straight water with a brush, and then like I'm noticing, oh, I want a little bit more darkness, so I'm going back and I'm reinforcing with ink, so that way I can get the brush will then spread the ink more. and it's just water. And he, but what's wonderful about this pen is that when it becomes fully dry, it does become waterproof. And that is a nice little feature to have. Let's see. Yeah. And the water just softens my lines just a little bit where I want to add a little bit of something extra. And yeah, it's just kind of a fun little experiment. And so I really encourage you guys, if y'all want to play with the effects and like kind of drawing with watercolor, but you don't want to always be getting your watercolor kit out and, you know, getting all your paints out and all that other stuff, I encourage you to go out and get a Kuratake brush pen. This one that I'm using is a Kuratake number 13 fountain brush pen, which has its own dip capabilities, which then allows me to change out the ink if I want to.